maybe a lot more money.
So now, Mr. and Mrs. Lamb.
Plenty of fails. Not for him.
What's that?
Well, some of the girls are.
Oh, yes, there is.
The flower girls.
Oh, okay.
I don't know how many, but.
No,
no,
we know.
I
think they're just gonna sit in the car.
Come on,
see. Oh, really?
Okay.
Robert.
Okay, now what? What does that
Kate
mean?
What?
Oh. Hey, I'll sit over here.
Have another drink? Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, give her a hug now and then, Dean.
There we go.
He'll hold you and let you cry.
Okay. Oh, is that right?
Oh, yeah, right.
Well, if you're like me, you'll nibble. It'll be okay.
You got a long ways to walk, don't you?
Yeah,
do.
Hey, I was up at 3, so.
Good job, Tommy.
Oh, thanks, Mom. I feel nap time's coming, though.
Right now, right? Nap time?
Nap time.
Things don't work like they used to before, and I can't sweep you off of your floor. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from the tears? Darling, I will be loving you. My heart.
welcome, everybody. Thank you for coming. You can be seated now.
Thank you.
All right. This is my first time doing this, so bear with me. But it's going to be great. It's such a great day here. It's just an honor for me to be here, to be part of the family, and to be asked to do this. So it's great to look out here and see all these family and friends and loved ones, and just how important and special that this day is. So marriage is a sacred institution, the basis of human society, and should be held in high honor among all men and women. We are assembled here in the presence of God, and these witnesses today to join Charlie and Lori in holy marriage, which is instituted by God, regulated by His Word, and blessed by our Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the well-being and happiness of mankind. Jesus Christ declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife. Both husband and wife are to cherish mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's frailties and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, and in honesty and labor to provide for each other and for their household. In temporal things, to pray for and encourage each other in things pertaining to God, and to live together as heirs of grace. And now at this point, I just wanted to share when I had first met Charlie and when I had first met Lori. Uh-oh. I'll start with Lori. I grew up in Eagle Creek Trailer Park, right across the street from her and her family and my beautiful wife, her daughter. And I would have never met Lori if she would have never given birth to her daughter. And I would never have been able to be part of this family. And so that's part of the reason why it's such a blessing and honor for me to be here. Okay. Charlie. From my memory, first time I met Charlie was down at the Fearless. Got a phone call. Her and Lori and Charlie were there, and somebody needed to come up and get her car. They've been drinking a little bit. So I jogged, we just went down the street, so I jogged up there, and in the back of my mind I'm thinking, okay, who's this character? I got to go up here and size him up. We always got to be looking out for Mom, right? So anyways, in the long run, as soon as I met Charlie, looked at me in my eye and squeezed my hand, like we did that day. I knew right away he was a good guy, and he's always been there whenever my family needed him or anything like that. So that's another good reason why I'm honored to be here. So, okay, we got that out of the way. And on that note, we need to invite the Lord here now and say a prayer before we get going any further. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for allowing us to gather here today, allowing us everyone to get here safely. We just allow you to, or just invite you to be here today and bless this marriage and bless everyone here, Lord. And thank you again for all the great things. In Jesus' name, amen. All right. And now, I'd like to read something from Ephesians, which is a little clearer on my smartphone app than what I've printed out here. It's a little friendlier language. This is instructions for the Christian household for marriage. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, submit to yourselves, to your own husbands, as you do the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, for his body, of which he is the Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by washing with the water through the word, through the word and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkles or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. After all, no one ever hated their own body, but they feed and care for their body just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Charlie, do you solemnly agree before God and these witnesses to take Lori to be your lawful wedded wife, to love and respect her, honor and cherish her, in health and in sickness, in prosperity and adversity, and leaving all others to keep yourself only to unto her, so as long as you both shall live. And Lori, do you in a like manner solemnly agree to receive Charlie as your lawful wedded husband, to love and respect him, and to live with him in all faith and tenderness, in health and in sickness, in prosperity and in adversity, and leaving all others to keep yourself only unto him, so as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Please join me. Repeat the following after me. I, Charlie, take you, Lori, to be my wedded wife. And I do promise with all my heart, God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. I, Lori, take you, Charlie.
I, Lori, take you, Charlie.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I do promise.
And I do promise.
With all my heart.
With all my heart.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
Plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
Joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
And at this point, the ring bearer comes up. Okay. As this ring is an endless circle made of precious pure metal, may it ever symbolize the purity and endlessness of your love for each other, day after day, year after year. And now you say, this ring I give you, in token and in pledge, of our constant and abiding love. This ring I give you.
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 In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant and abiding love.
Of our constant and abiding love.
And now, I need to say another prayer. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for allowing me to stumble through this. And it's just, we all know in the end it comes out beautiful. And that's the way you designed it. And we just just want to give praise and thanks again in Jesus' name. Okay. By the authority committed unto me as a minister, I now declare Charlie and Lori are now husband and wife according to the ordinances of God and the laws of this state. God having joined these two together in holy matrimony, let no man seek to dissolve this union. You may kiss your bride. Gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Charlie Lamb.
Thank you. running.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, everybody put your hands together and welcome to the party, Mr. and Mrs. Lamb, right over there.
We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect.
Get those pictures. Yeah, bounce a little too, Mr. Lamb. Show you got some rhythm.
Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned. Come on, get it started. Come on, get it started. Get it started. Let's get it started.
All right, one more time. Big round of applause for the brand new bride and groom right here. That's about as bouncy as you get, right, sir? All right, good enough. All right, you guys relax.
Very, very, like, stern.
Second to him. Quick.
Oh, my gosh.
But wait, me too.
Who made this?
We're asking everyone.
Alyssa made it.
Charlie.
No. There you go. I cut that in half, Charlie. And Charlie, I gotta tell you something. According to Oregon tradition, the groom always feeds the bride first. Always. The reason why that is, Charlie, he doesn't care.
Alright,
well, you need to officially feed him a piece of cake. This is your day, do whatever you want, okay? Now give a big smooch right there behind the cake. Big smooch. There you go.
There's no food on the plate. You can smash it.
Give him a round of applause. Very good.
Smash it in for me.
Are you ready for cake?
Yeah.
Are you hungry?
It's really now the tough time for Charlie to let go of the plates of food. We'll have somebody serve it for us.
All right, guys. I can't cut a cake. Do I look like I cut anything? No.
I think you left me laugh.
No. You look like you're cut a cheese.
You just amused me. That's a good thing. All right, I'm going to let you guys go out right in the middle of the grass there. And I'm going to give you two chances, okay?
Okay. Find Shauna. Find Shauna.
Good things.
First dance together as husband and wife. All right, right now we want all the bridal party to join the bride and groom out on the dance floor. Special wedding party dance song. Where are you guys at?
Jerry, you better come down.
There she is. All the little ones, too. Go ahead, sir. You're done? All right. All right, bring them on. Bring on the rest of the wedding party.
Take the drink.
Do you want that to have a drink? Annabelle!
No more counting dollars. We'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars.
Makes me feel alive. I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be.
Are you ready? How many of those are you gonna throw? Just that one? Okay. On the count of three, ladies, you ready? You ready? Here we go. One, two, three. You look surprised. Are you surprised? All right, so I need the best man out here. I need the bride and groom out here.
Gotta hold it up.
And I need the maid of honor.
Gotta hold
here.
It up.
Out here in the middle.
Come on. Don't be shy.
And Stacy.
How the fuck did I catch Stacy?
Too many mistakes, better get this right.